Welcome to this demo for SAS Global Forum 2020. I'm Guohui Wu at SAS. In this demo, we will talk about spatial econometric modeling for big data using SAS econometrics. First, a little bit background information about spatial econometric modeling. Spatial econometric models extend standard econometric models to address spatial interaction and heterogeneity in cross-sectional and panel data. The motivation behind spatial econometric modeling is the first law of geography, which says everything is related to everything else, but near things are more related than distant things. From the modeling point of view, the first law of geography suggests that data collected across different units in space are often correlated, and the strength of such dependence is determined by the proximity of two units in space. In spatial econometric modeling, spatial weight matrix, often known as W matrix, plays an important role because it describes the proximity of two units in space. Our choice of models also plays an important role because we need to address various forms of spatial dependence in the data. In this demo, we will focus on the C-spatialreg procedure in SAS econometrics, which was developed for spatial econometric modeling. As we have already mentioned in the previous slide, W matrix describes neighbor relationships among observation units. Generally speaking, W is an n by n matrix with non-negative entries, where n is the number of unique observation units in the data. Wij, or the ij's entry of W, is positive if units I and j are neighbors. We use W matrix to parameterize spatial interaction and dependence. As an example, let's look at a general modeling framework that is described by the two equations given here. In the first equation, the first summation term accounts for spatial endogenous interaction, whereas the second summation term accounts for spatial exogenous interaction. Moreover, the second equation accounts for spatial interaction in the error term. To create a spatial weight matrix W, we can use neighbor criteria such as contiguity, distance, and many more. Now, let's look at two examples. In this first example, we consider a dataset that contains median home values for 506 census tracts in Boston. Four variables in this dataset are selected for the analysis. Our dependent variable, met value, refers to median value of owner-occupied homes in $1,000, and it is measured on log scale. Two explanatory variables are PT ratio and status, both of which are measured on log scale. Here, PT ratio refers to pupil-teacher ratio per ton, and status refers to percentage of lower status population. Tract is the variable that refers to census tract ID code. The figure on the right panel plots MAT value, from which we can see that median home values for neighboring census tracts seem to be similar, which might suggest some kind of spatial dependence in the data. For this analysis, we consider a spatial weight matrix W that is created based on sphere of influence. You can fit various spatial econometric models to Boston housing data using PROC CSPATIALREG. For the purpose of demonstration, we only consider six models and provide their AIC values here. These six models, ranked by their AIC values, are linear regression model, spatial lag of X model, spatial autoregressive model, spatial ER model, spatial Durbin ER model, and spatial Durbin model. If AIC is used for model selection, spatial Durbin model, or SDM, is the winning model because its AIC value is the smallest. The lower right panel shows you the SAS code that is used to fit SDM and to test the null hypothesis rho equals zero using both Ward and Lagrange multiplier or LM tests. The impact option is specified to request impact estimate summary table. The test results table here shows you the result from both Ward and LM tests, from which we cannot accept the null hypothesis at 5% significance level. Now, let's look at parameter and impact estimates from SDM. The first table here shows you the prompt estimate from SDM, whereas the second table summarizes impact estimates for two explanatory variables. Here we note that the average direct impact for PT ratio is negative 0.435, which is different from its point estimate of negative 0.419 in the prompt estimates table. Moreover, the average indirect and total impacts for PT ratio are negative 0.184 and negative 0.619, respectively. As a result, we conclude that 1% increase in pupil-teacher ratio in a census tract leads to a total of 0.62% decrease in home value. Similarly, we conclude that 1% increase in percentage of lower status population in a census tract leads to a total of 0.57% decrease in home value. The take-home message here is that prompt estimates from spatial econometric models do not always have the same straightforward interpretation as in classical linear regression models. PROC CSPATIALREG also supports two approximation methods. These two approximation methods are Chebyshev approximation and Taylor approximation. For the purpose of demonstration, we also fit SDM to Bostonhausen data using Chebyshev approximation. The table on the left panel shows the prompt estimates from SDM without approximation, whereas the table on the right panel shows you the prompt estimate from SDM with Chebyshev approximation. Then comparison between these two tables shows that the prompt estimate from SDM with and without approximation are very similar. However, fitting SDM to Bostonhausen data using Chebyshev approximation can reduce computation time significantly. To further demonstrate how the CSPATIALREG procedure scales to big data, we consider a simulated data set in our second example. In this simulation, we create a spatial weight matrix W for 64,999 census tracts in a 2000 US census based on three nearest neighbor criteria. Using this W, we then simulate data from the Chu model, which is a spatial autoregressive or SAR model using the two parameter values given here. When fitting the two model to this simulated data set, we'll be facing two main challenges. Memory-wise, storing the full W matrix requires about 30 gigabytes of memory. Computationally, fitting the two model to this simulated data set with exact computation is almost infeasible. However, these two challenges are resolved in the CSPATIALREG procedure, which allows the procedure to scale to big data. You can fit the Chu model to this simulated data set using PROC CSPATIALREG with approximation, and the total computation time is about 1 minute. The table on the right panel shows you the prompt estimates from PROC CSPATIALREG. We compare the prompt estimates with their true values and find that the prompt estimates are very close to their true values. Now, let's look at the values of dependent variable in the simulated dataset and their in-sample predicted values. The figure on the left panel shows you the plot for the dependent variable y in the simulated dataset, whereas the figure on the right panel shows you the plot for predicted values. The comparison between these two figures shows that the predicted values capture the overall pattern in the simulated data very well. This is expected given that the prompt estimates are very close to the true values. Thank you for your time, and I hope you enjoyed this demo. If you have any questions, you can reach me by email at guohui.wu@sas.com.